Endorsed by ATP professional Dominic Thiem, this is the Babolat Pure Strike 1820. Babolat updates the Pure Strike 1820 with the Project 17 cosmetic and new technologies. It has new FSI Power Technology and hybrid frame construction for a responsive and lively feel. Babolat has thickened the beams and parts of the shaft and head for enhanced power and stability. The racquet features a stiffness rating of 67, a 325 swing weight, and a 4 points headlight balance. First up, we have Hannah. Now, the Pure Strike 16x19 is your current racquet of choice. What do you think of this different string pattern?
So with this frame, the last couple of months, I've just been able to get a lot of pop on my shots. It's really complemented my game. The sweet spot is just really nice, and I get that comfortable feel all around the court, which I really like. And so with this 18x20 swing pattern, the biggest difference I noticed was that I was just able to take a fuller swing with my shots, which was actually really nice. And I got to hit a different shot than I could with the 16x19, where I could really come around my wrist. The one downside to this was that I did just have to be a lot more precise and get in position better on court. With the 16x19, I'm just offered a lot more forgiveness when the ball is closer to my body. I can still produce a good deep shot with that pop, and same when I'm on the run out hitting a shot, I can still get that same deep power. Overall, the stability I found was really good around serve, return, and volleys. The same aspects I like of the frame, just more stable. So just really impressed with this racquet and good play test.
Next up, we have Chris. Now, you play tested the previous Pure Strike 18x20 and you're a big fan of it. What did you think of this update?
Yeah, I really like that racquet. I was probably the biggest fan here at T-Dub of the old Pure Strike 18x20. And this one is just way better. The beam is the same as the Project 17, the 16x19, which I love that racquet. I could switch to that racquet in a heartbeat. I love this one even more, the 18x20 string pattern. I'm a big fan of the dense string bears. I come from a long history of using rackets with 18x20 string pattern, so it just fit my game really well. Loved it on my backhand slice, which is kind of, you know, some days the only shot I've got. So I was really able to work that shot well with this racket. I could move the ball around the court well. I could control my depth. Really liked hitting drop shots with this racket too. And then at net, a lot of touch and feel. It was down a tad on power and topspin compared to the 16x19 Project 17 racket, but I got that back with more control and feel, and that worked well on approach shots. And again, at net and stuff. Just on serve, you know, maybe missing a little bit of power, especially from my Pure Drive Plus, but this is a racket I really loved. I could switch to this one. It's probably one of my favorite play tests in recent memory.
Next up, we have Jason. Your racket of choice is also the Pure Strike 16x19. How did the 18x20 string pattern work out for your more spin-friendly game?
I love the 16x19. Obviously, I switched to it, but I love this 18x20 as well. I felt like they both kind of have that solid, responsive feel. They're both pretty maneuverable, pretty user-friendly. The one biggest difference I noticed for me, like Hannah mentioned, was that lack of power versus with the 18x20 versus the 16x19. But it is more control-oriented. So I felt like I was able to be more aggressive, kind of take fuller cuts at the ball, and just have a more aggressive mindset when it came to attacking the ball. Whereas with the 16x19, it did allow me to have more free power, but in the same vein, I was also spraying the ball a little bit more with the 16x19 versus the 18x20. So I enjoyed both very much. I think the one slight downside for me with this racket would be that the sweet spot felt a little bit smaller and less forgiving. But other than that, between the two rackets, I'd say it's a toss-up. For me, I would probably go with the 16x19 just a bit because of a little bit more power. But for players that are a bit stronger, definitely check out the 18x20.
I also play tested this racket as well as the previous Pure Strike 18x20. And the biggest update I found was the feel. I love the crisp, lively responsiveness that I got from this racket. On my ground strokes, while I did get a little bit less power than I'm used to, I love the control. I love to be able to control my depth on my ground strokes and place it anywhere I liked. Up at net, I came in and I thought the racket was fast feeling, and I also felt I could do a lot at net. I felt very connected to the string bed, so I could hit a lot of shorter volleys as well as punch the volley deep. I also couldn't choose between whether I liked to serve or return better with this racket. I felt very accurate on my serves, but I also felt stable on my returns and I could really go after them. My one negative would be that I'm not a big fan of the 18x20. I use 16x19s mostly, so I felt like I was missing a little bit of spin potential, especially when I'm trying to pull my opponents off the court with a shorter angled ground stroke. Overall though, I really enjoy the feel of this racket. I just prefer 16 by 19s. We play tested the Babolat Pure Strike 18 by 20 with Solinko Hyper-G, strung at around 53 pounds. For more information on this racket, please check it out on tenniswarehouse.com or one of our fine affiliates.